understand this. You're changing, I can't stand it. My heart can't take this damage. And the way I feel, can't stand it. Maybe I don't understand this.
It's only better for Justin. This is what he wants. Are you really just gonna let him win?
I'm really worried about him, and if he doesn't get back into class, he's going to fail us.
My heart can't take this damage. And the way I think it's
dead. What? What did she call me way more than that? What? What?
Changing, I can't stand it. My heart can't take this damage. And the way I feel can't stand it. Can't stand it. My heart can't take this damage. And the way I feel, can't stand it. Maybe I don't understand it.
Hey guys, I'm Nico Biala. I played Walter last year for our movie Crush, and it's officially been 1 year since that movie has come out, and behind the camera is actually the person who played Ted. His name is AJ, if you want to say so.
I don't do the camera stuff very often, so I'm not trying to mess this up.
But we have returned to the campus since it's been over a year, and we're going to check out the place a little bit so we can walk around. As you can see, the place has changed a little bit. Over here used to be actually the tree where Mr. Wilson and Walter were talking about relationships and all that stuff, but the school took it out for some reason. I have no idea why. The place has changed quite a bit since we last filmed. It was under construction. I think you could tell throughout the movie that the set was under construction, but now everything's almost all done pretty much, and everything's all clean, so we kind of filmed at the wrong time last year. Around here was where we met up last year when it came to for production. We came back over here every time we had to meet.
A lot of running around the campus trying to meet with Mr. Wilson.
Yeah, took quite a few times to meet up with your dad in order to...
Oh, gosh.
But as you can see, behind where we were is now a new building that's being made. That wasn't there last year.
Oh, yeah, no.
And over here on this side was where the initial heartbreak scene actually happened. The scene where Walter gets rejected by Penny and all that stuff.
Wasn't there a thing? Where did we do? Was it around there where we did the post-breakup scene? You get the text from Penny and she's like...
Oh, yes, it was. It was at the... it was near the gym.
Okay.
That's why. So, we are back. We're back where we first started.
It was good.
The movie has officially been, at this point, been released for over a year. We debuted August 27th, 2021. Man.
That was a good debut.
Yeah, it was.
That was fun. It was great. It turned out great.
A question that I've been thinking of since then has just, like, what has changed about us, or, like, in terms of, like, how we feel about the movie since... It took 3 years to make that movie, and we finally... This was the first year where we're like, it doesn't have to be a problem anymore.
I didn't know how good it was going to be until it came out. Mm. You know, I didn't know until I saw it all together.
Yeah.
That it was really something. You know, we filmed plenty of things. Some things never get made. I mean, Crush almost didn't get made, this we were talking about.
Yeah. Yeah, Crush almost didn't get made. Luckily, we found time, and it was a good time during the year where we were feeling more comfortable, and we actually felt like we could film the movie. What did you think of the outcome of the movie overall? I mean, I know obviously a lot of people have said like, oh, it was a good movie and all that stuff, but in terms of like how we originally started and now how it ended, how did you feel? Were you satisfied? Like, did you think it was like maybe we could have done better?
You mean in terms of like the plot? Or just the production?
In the whole movie overall. Like, when you watched the movie, like, were you like, oh, I'm satisfied with this? Or were you like,
no, it was
think
good.
There could have been more.
I think it was good. I think I'm glad that it wasn't just like a generic, like, oh, they messed up, but they figured it out, and they're together. Like, that's overdone. That's overplayed, right?
Yeah.
I'm glad that there were some consequences for people's actions.
Yeah.
You know, people messed up and they had to deal with it.
Yeah, yeah.
But in the end, you know, people came to terms with their things, and that's good. But at least it wasn't, you know, I feel like a lot of movies are kind of lazy when it comes to people, like, you know what I mean.
I know what you mean.
You know, it's like, oh, there's all this hijinks, and now it's all fine at the end. It wasn't that fine at the end.
No,
but I think that's good.
Yeah. The whole thing with Walter was that I didn't want to give him this satisfying, happy ending. I didn't want him to obviously get the girl, but I also wanted him to realize about himself, like, oh, there's a lot more that I got to improve about myself before I even think about, like, trying to go after a girl.
I mean, you know, he messed up. He had to own up to the fact that he, you know, he hurt people, or her at least, you know, and hurt other people in the process of all this chaos. And it's good, you know, it's good. It's different, it's good.
How important do you think the movie was at the end of the day? Because I always contemplate of, like, what was the true meaning of the movie and, like, how much of an effect did the story have on people?
I think this was a big thing for the Dream Project. You know, a lot of Dream Project stuff, rightfully so, is very funny. And, like, Roomies.
Roomies, but, our next feature film, is very funny.
But,
it was different.
No, a lot of it is pretty goofy, but this one was very heartfelt, very thought through, and tried to avoid being basic, at least when it mattered. You know, you have some tropes in there, but everything has some tropes in there.
Yeah.
And I think it's good when you set something up to have a bunch of tropes and then you spin them around at the end.
Yeah.
Right? That's you know, I think that's good storytelling. and so I think it was great to have, you know, the Dream Project come in with a big, you know, impactful, emotionally relevant movie. And I think that being at the premiere, everybody who saw it kind of felt it. You know, they were like, I get where this is going, I get where it's coming from, and I get why it's here.
I always say this about Crush. I don't believe Crush is a romance in any kind of way, because although it was obviously about somebody who liked someone, there was no romantic type of, I feel like there was no romantic feel in that movie aside from Walter's feelings towards Penny.
Sure.
And that's kind of why the movie was called Crush, because it was about one side of the story rather than about two people liking each other.
I didn't even think about that.
Yeah, no.
I didn't even think about that.
It was
Walter's
perspective the whole time.
Yeah, no, and I think it was good. I mean, you know, Walter had a crush, and that meant something to him. But then at the end, it's him realizing that he doesn't need a crush to have that, that faith in himself.
Yeah,
you know.
Question: hypothetically, if there was a crush too, obviously, which there will not be, where do you think Walter's story would go from there? Or actually, more interesting question is, where do you think Penny's story will go from there?
As for Penny, I don't really know. Because I think so much of Crush was told from Walter's perspective. That there's a lot we don't know about Penny. And you don't always think about that, you know, because you're looking at the movie as itself.
Yeah.
I don't really know where Penny's story would go, because we don't know all that much about her, because we only have seen the parts that were relevant to Walter and his crush.
Yeah.
Right? So you could do a whole world of things with Penny's story that are completely separate.
I don't know. Hypothetically, it'd be a very interesting perspective to see it from Penny's perspective, because the way her story ended, from what I remember, was that obviously she hated the fact that she hurt Walter, but, you know, she felt like they couldn't be together for a good reason. She didn't think she was ready. She didn't think he was ready. And obviously she was okay with the whole moving thing from going from here to New Jersey or Washington, because she wanted a fresh start. Mm-hmm. So she didn't exactly end her story in a way that her story was satisfied.
Yeah.
Neither was Walter's. To wrap this whole entire thing up, I just wanted to say it's been an amazing, you know, it was an amazing time to really make that movie. You know, making it last year was honestly one of the most memorable times of my life because of how just kind of fun we kind of took it. It was the first time we ever made a movie that felt, you know, so real and serious.
Oh, yeah.
And we took production, you know, super high for that. And we didn't really try to screw around with it. So, yeah, it was honestly one of my favorite times ever making that movie. And, you know, to everybody out there, the reason why I first wrote the movie was because, you know, of heartbreak. And I feel like that's a very serious topic that should be talked about more often because everybody gets heartbroken once in their life in some shape or form. Whether it's the way that Walter got, you know, heartbroken through rejection, or, you know, even if it's just like a best friend that backstabbed you, everybody gets heartbroken in some way. And I felt like with this movie, I felt like we could have sent out a message that was at least saying it was going to be okay no matter whatever it was. We hope that you guys take the message right, and it's not saying, yeah, like try to do what Walter did, but more so be try to learn from Walter and his mistakes. Mm-hmm. And Walter wasn't so much a inspiration from me or like anybody else. He was more so written to be a symbol for everybody out there in the world that was heartbroken and needs help. So if you're feeling heartbroken out there and you feel depressed or in some way, shape, or form, please find some sort of, you know, help for yourself, whether it's just talking to a friend or if it's doing something new with your life, whatever it is, find some help out there. And because I assure you that it exists, and you should never give up on your life because of it. So yeah, I think that's about it. Thank you guys very much for everything.
Thank you.